Hey everyone. In this fixed point method example video, we are asked to solve for the root of the function e to the power of 0.5x minus x minus 2. So, if you remember from our previous video, the fixed point method is an open root finding method used in numerical methods. So, this question is asking us to find the point at which this function here crosses the x-axis, which as we know is called a function's root. Let's just quickly throw on a graph of what this function looks like. Now, as we talked about in our previous fixed point method videos, our first step to solving a fixed point method is solving for one of our x variables. With this function, we can create two other functions that we will call g1 of x and g2 of x. Solving through, we can see that g1 of x is equal to e to the power of 0.5x minus 2, and g2 of x is equal to 2 ln x plus 2. So, let's just plot g1 of x and g2 of x on our graph here. So, in the fixed point method, the fixed point is directly above our root of interest, which our g of x functions intersect with a line where our input equals our output. Now, we can choose either equation here to begin solving. Sometimes both equations will work, sometimes only one will work, or sometimes neither will work. However, as I mentioned in our fixed point convergence video, if the slope of the tangent line is greater than 1 in absolute terms, at our root, then the fixed point method will never converge. Examining our graph, it is clear that at g2 of x, the slope is rather intense, around x root. Therefore, convergence with g2 of x is going to be impossible. We can validate this by trying a few starting guesses, and as you see, we always diverge away from our solution. So, we are left to begin using g1 of x to solve for our function's root. As you can see here, we have many starting guesses that would work. However, remember if our slope within our region of interest becomes too large, we will not converge. And as you can see here, that can be caused by a poor starting guess. So let's just choose 2 as our starting guess. To begin solving for our root, we begin by plugging our initial guess into our function. This gives an output of 0.718. Now all we need to do is continually plug our previous output as our next iteration's input. Therefore, for iteration 1 here, we get minus 0.5679. Now, we should be converging, as that is what we are beginning to see here graphically. So let's validate that with our percent error formula. Our initial error is 226%. Now, iteration 2, we plug in x1 and we get minus 1.247. And this gives us a 54.4% error, which makes sense as we are narrowing in on our fixed point. Repeating for iteration 3, we get minus 1.464. And that gives us a percent error of 14.8%. So, because this is still above our required error, we need to repeat at least one more iteration. Plugging x3 into our g of x function, we get x4 is minus 1.519, and that results in an error of 3.62%, which is accurate enough for us. Therefore, we can formally state that the root of the function f of x is at minus 1.1519 with a 3.62% error. I hope that this video helped your understanding of how to solve for the root of a function using the fixed point method. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking that join button down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below, and I will do my best to address your concerns.